Hi everyone, hope you all are doing well. My name is Atharali and I will teach you computer science. Today we are going to start our first chapter, that is Introduction to Computer Science. And in this chapter we will be discussing topics like history of computation, types of computers with respect to function and size, and the applications of computer in different walks of life. So let's start our first topic. So as you can see, in this lecture, we will talk about the history of computation, that is how the computers evolved with the passage of time and how the changes in the computer took place. When we talk about history, we will be discussing different computing devices in different periods of time, called as ages. For our convenience, we can divide the history of computer in three different ages, as you can see in the slide. The first age is called as Dark Ages. Dark Ages mainly consist of those devices which are manually operated. Manually operated means the devices which are forced by or which are operated by human force. Then we will discuss Middle Ages devices. Middle Ages mainly consist of mechanical devices. Then we have Modern Ages devices. These devices mainly consist of electronic devices. We will later on see the meanings of these terms, mechanical, manual, and electronic later on. Now, the journey of computers start from 3000 BC. 3000 BC means 3000 before Christ, when the first computing device, abacus, was invented in China. It was invented in China, and this computer was used for counting, trading, and doing complex calculations. As you can see in the diagram, it is a simple device in which there are some small objects. These objects are called as beads, and these beads were made from stones. In that period of time, these beads were made from stones, and these were used for counting by moving them upward and downward. Then similarly, this device is divided into two main parts. The first part is called as upper deck, and the lower part is called as lower deck. The casing of this device is called as frame. This is why it is also called as counting frames. This device is also called as counting frame. The center part of this device is called as beam. So it was used for a very long time for counting, trading, addition, subtraction, and multiplication. And do remember that it is a manual device. What does it mean? It means it was powered by humans. Human force was required to run it. So all the devices of Dark Ages were mainly manual devices. Now there are some other manual devices, just like Napier booms and outright slide rule. In 1617, a mathematician, John Napier invented another manual device for calculation of multiplication and division of large numbers. This device consists of 11 rods with numbers marked on them. By the way, can you search on Google and tell me that John Napier is also famous for invention of some other thing? Give me answer in the comment section of KP. Now, another important and notable device of this age, that is we are talking about the Dark Age, was developed by William Outright in 1632. It was an improved version of Napier booms, which involved some kind of machine. So it was some sort of manual mechanical device. It was not purely manual device. It involved some kind of machinery in it. That is why it is called as a manual mechanical device. And that would be the topic, our next topic. In the next topic, we will be discussing the mechanical computing devices that starts from 1641 and it ends in 1890. From 1641 to 1890, some mechanical computing devices were invented. And unlike manual devices, these mechanical devices are those devices which have got some kind of machines in it. So that's all for today. In the next lecture, we will be discussing these mechanical computing devices. So take care. Allah Hafiz.